Welcome friends, on this video tutorial, Daniel is here from Tips to Fix. Today I'm going to show you a new method how to install Windows 11 on unsupported computers on 2025, okay? This is the first video for this year and it will be great, okay? Super easy, easier than before, you don't have to write any CMD commands, guys, it's amazing. One of Tips to Fix subscribers wrote me a comment on the other video tutorial, famous video tutorial that I did for installing Windows 11 24H2, method that he suggested was super amazing. So today I tested, I'm going to show you how it works and it's easier than all the other methods. I will cover everything you need to know to install Windows 11 on 2025. I know it's difficult for you to decide what to do to install or not install Windows 11 on your old computer. I'm going to show you and suggest you what Windows version you need to install on your computer without crashing your system and without damaging your work. Okay, guys? So let's go ahead and let me show you the new method. So now, as you already know, first thing that we are going to do is we have to check our processor. We have to check our minimum requirements. First thing you gotta do, go to properties. You wanted to see your processor. Here is your processor. Mine is Intel Core i7-4500K. It's good processor, as you already know. But it's unsupported, okay? So it's generation 7. Okay, let's see now the minimum requirements from Windows 11, okay? Windows 11 requirements on Google, go ahead. Here, Windows specify, okay? So you will see here the specific version. So processor 1 GHz or faster with 2 or more core. Make sure your Windows 10 is not in 32-bit. Your Windows 10 version need to be on 64-bit processor. If your Windows 10 is 32-bit on your computer, then upgrading to Windows 11 will not work. The reason why your computer will have 32 is that you install it already or your processor does not support 64-bit. Then make sure you have more than 4 GB. I mean, 4 GB is minimum, 4 GB RAM. With 2 GB RAM, you are not able to upgrade on Windows 11, okay? And storage need to be 46 or larger. I'm going to download this PC health check because we need to check the computer and see if this computer will be supported. I'm downloading it and installing. Open PC health check. Yes, check now. My processor doesn't meet minimum requirements. TPM is okay, 2.0 is enabled. Secure boot is enabled on BIOS. Okay, I enable secure boot on BIOS. Now, what if you wanted to enable TPM 2.0 and you wanted to meet all the requirements, and also if you want to convert from MBR to GPT, watch the other video tutorial that I did exactly for this topic, okay? Now, you see my processor does not support. Mine is on generation 7. Look, go to performance here. See, my processor is on generation 7. But if your computer is older than this, I mean, in generation 3, 2, I mean, Core 2 Duo, if you have a processor Core 2 Duo or processor Core 2 Quad or Athlon processor, AMD Athlon, 64-bit, very old computers, do not install Windows 11 24H2. Install 23H2 because it will crash your system. We are going to check your processor if support SSE 4.2 and POPCNT, okay? Download CPU-Z here, find download button, scroll down, download now, on apps here, on CPU, you see CPU here, instructions, we have SSE 2, 3, SSE 4.1, 4.2, okay? We are good to go because we have 4.2 and this will support Windows 11 24H2. Watch the other video tutorial that I did exactly for this topic and I did all the tests and you will see what will happen with your computer if you install Windows 11 latest version, okay? Go ahead, click the link on the description. I mean, for generation 7, 6, 4, 5 will be great to upgrade on 24H2, okay guys? So now we need to download. I'm going to download the latest version, Windows 11. Download. Guys, make sure that your computer, date and time here, okay? Make sure you are not on the past or on the future, okay? And you will not be able to download Windows 11. Loading forever because you need to fix your date and time. Now, which version of Windows 11 you need to download? Here, Windows 11 Multi-Edition for sure. But What about the language? Click this download button. Error. I'm going to sync my data in time. Maybe I have a problem with this. I'm going to refresh the page and select the version and click download. Error. I'm going to open up Edge, Microsoft Edge. Paste. Let's try with Microsoft Edge. It works well with Microsoft Edge. Which language you need to download now? See, choose one. You need to download the same language as your Windows 10 is already installed. Yeah, I need this command here. I'm going to copy this command because I'm going to run as administrator. I need to see my language. Paste this command. Now my Windows language is EN United States. In my case, it will be this version here, English United States. But if you are in Canada or United Kingdom, download English International. For me, it's English United States. Now download here 64-bit. And let's wait a little bit for this download. Okay, here we have the ISO file. I'm going to drag and drop here on my desktop. Don't forget, extract the ISO. I had a lot of comments in my earlier videos that this process mostly happen on when you try to mount the disk and install it from there. I suggest you extract the ISO. Let me show you how to do it. If you don't know how to extract, you don't have WinRAR or 7-zip, go ahead, download WinRAR here. It's free. I mean, use the free version. Yes. Yes, or 7-zip. Depends on you, okay? Now, right-click on the file here and extract here to the folder, okay? Now, this will be extracted on a folder. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to install. I'm going to upgrade from this Windows 10 to Windows 11, the latest version. Okay, now, open up the folder. You see here on the folder, we have all the files that we need. Watch carefully now. This is super easy. It's official, super easy. Right click here inside of the folder. Okay, here inside the folder. Create new file, text document. Okay, name it setup. Okay, click enter. Now, open up this Word and write setup space slash, not this slash, the other one, this one here, slash product server space server, and that's it. Save. Now watch carefully. So as you already know, let's go here on folder. Now this file here is Word, I mean is text, but we want to make this executable. Okay, to do this, you see this extension here, .fei. We don't see here .txt file. We need to make this bat, okay, bat system. To do this executable, what you are going to do, you are going to go here on view, click here view, okay, and then you will see here folder options. Click on the folder options, go to view here, view tab, you see guys. Now, you see this, hide extensions for known file types. Then remove this button here. Click apply. Click OK. Now you see setup.txt. Now, replace this txt here and write it bat. Enter. Now, click yes. Super easy. Now what I'm going to do, double click on this file. You see, will pop up directly. Do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? It will install Windows, okay? Click yes. Now, watch carefully. I told you it's super easy. Okay, what is this product server? I don't want Windows Server on my computer. I just want Windows 11. Yes, It's Windows 11, but it's another door. It's the same setup form for Windows Server without requirements TPM 2.0 or secure boot or your processor doesn't support. So this method will skip all these requirements and it's official directly by Microsoft. Here, change how setup downloads. I don't want to download any updates for the moment because we have to update later. Not right now. And click next. Okay. Click accept here. Now, keep files and settings. I told you, if you wanted to see this option clickable like this, make sure to download the same Windows version that you already are on Windows 10. Okay, guys? If you don't want to see this gray out, then go ahead, download the same version of your Windows language. I need to keep every single files and settings and apps and everything, guys. I have OBS here. I have Google Chrome. I have a lot of softwares that I use for recording and for other purposes. I don't want to lose anything, okay? But before you install, make sure to backup your computer, all the data. Put it on a D drive. I don't have D drive here, but create a D drive. Put all the files on D drive. I mean, if you have any problem with C drive, if you have any error during setup, you don't want to lose the files, go ahead, create a new drive. You know what? I did another video tutorial for this, how to create D drive on your computer. Go watch. It's on the description and it's here on the cards also, okay? Go ahead, watch the video how to create a D drive, okay? To keep the data, keep the files and everything, okay? Keep files and settings, go next. Guys, this file that I create, you will find on my website. If you don't want to create it, even easier, go ahead, download it, use it. Bring it here. You have to bring it here on inside a folder that you already extract, okay? Okay, now I'm going to install and you will see that it will work. And after that, I'm going to show you some other things that you need to know if you face any error during install, what to do in this case, a lot of other tricks that you need to know. This setup, it will take some time and your computer will restart many times, okay? So as you see, the computer is restarting. Let's see now. Okay. So this process for me will be faster because I'm running on M2 drive, guys. If your computer is not that fast, if you are running on a hard drive, then I suggest you replace SSD drive, will be super faster. If you wanted to clone your computer to new drive, I did another video tutorial for that. I suggest you minimum 8 GB RAM. It will, your computer will be faster. Even if you're running on Windows 10 and you want to stay on 10, clean your GPU graphic card. I did another video for this. Go ahead and watch how to clean your GPU graphic card, make your computer faster. Working on updates 100%, please your computer on. And I'm on here. Super easy because I'm on generation 7. But if you are in Core 2 Duo, do not upgrade to 24H2. Please, guys, watch the other video tutorial that I did for this topic to see what is going on and what will happen in your computer if you upgrade your Core 2 Duo or Core 2 Quad processor on 24H2. Stay on 23H2. I'm showing you how to get 23H2 directly from Microsoft website. Sometimes it's harder because they put the newest there. But there are methods that Microsoft will give you the software on Windows that you need. Okay, see, now I'm here on the latest version of Windows 11. Windows 11 Pro 24H2, the latest version. Let's see updates, if updates are working. Great! You see the security updates are working, an update for Windows Security Platform, cumulative update for Windows 11. It will be here, guys. So as you see, it's downloading and it's working really well. Upgrading from Windows 10 to Windows 11, it's free, guys. If you already have a license for your Windows 10, then upgrading to Windows 11, it will be free. You will have the same version of Windows that you had before. If you are running on Windows 10 Home Edition, then Windows 11 will be the same. I mean, Windows 11 Home Edition. If you are running on Windows 10 Professional, then Windows 11 will be Windows 11 Professional. My Windows 11 Pro is already activated. It's because my Windows 10 was activated before, activated with a digital license. For any reason, if you see any problem on installing Windows 11, you're stuck on 40%, 50%, or I mean, you're stuck during the process, let me show you what you have to do. Go ahead, clear your Windows 11 temp cache, temp data, okay? Search for temp, delete temporary files here. Temporary files, I have 25 gigabytes, I have downloads, I don't want to clean downloads. Temporary windows, make sure to clean Windows update cleanup, temporary Windows installation files, make sure to clean this. Purview Windows installation file. I will keep downloads because I have a lot of files here. Now click this remove files. Okay. Wait for this process till the end and then go here on C drive. If you see windows.old, go ahead, delete this folder. What you gotta do, just start over and start the process from beginning. I had a lot of questions. Is this Windows 11 on unsupported computer faster than Windows 10? Let me show you something. I did a post on my community tab. There are a lot of people, 1,000 subscribers. They vote on the post that I did. So what you gotta do, just go ahead to my community tab and just vote here. You will be amazed by the results. We can talk a lot about who is faster, but it's better when you guys vote directly. It's a real opinion, it's a real thing. What about in 14 October, Windows 10 will end support? Then you will need to change your computer or you will need to upgrade to Windows 11. So guys, prepare for this, okay? I'm going to thank you for watching this video tutorial. You find this video helpful. Don't forget to share this video with your friends. It's the best video on YouTube. I know this is super easy and I covered this topic many times, okay? I'm going to say, as always guys, I wish this year, 2025, will be the best year ever for you guys. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.